In this video, we're going to talk about how to calculate an ethanol mix in your BMW. So this will work for any tune that you're trying to run, if it's for like E30, E40, E50, whatever. One thing I want to mention is if you have a race tonight or something and you want to go out and run an ethanol map and you're just trying to figure out how to do that really quickly, this won't really be the video for you. I do a lot of preliminary work and preparation to make sure that I'm getting the mix right. So I'm going to share with you the actual procedure that I use to make sure that I'm getting it right. Something else I want to address: a lot of people think that you need an ethanol analyzer before running a map for an ethanol mix, and that's not necessarily the case. I ran one without an ethanol analyzer for several months without an issue. It's kind of like having a TPMS sensor in your tire. All the analyzer will do is tell you if it's wrong after you've already, you know, left the gas station or driven away. So what's more important is making sure that you're calculating the mix accurately when you're filling up the car, and that way you know you won't have any issues in the future. The analyzer is just kind of for peace of mind, so you can check it. So these are the steps that I follow. The first thing you want to do is make sure that you find a good calculator or app that can help you figure out how much fuel to put into the car. Some people use spreadsheets, you know, on like Google Drive or something that they can access on their phone. This is the app that I use. It's on the Google Play Store because I have an Android phone. There are several other apps on there that work just fine. And there are plenty of apps on the Apple Store as well. The main thing that you want to figure out is an app that has fields like this one, where you can enter in the exact amount of fuel in your tank, the exact size of your fuel tank, you know, all of those different metrics, so you can get the fuel mix as accurate as possible. Some apps have like a little slider or something that make you estimate if you have 25%, 50%, 75% fuel, and those aren't going to get you as accurate. So find one that lets you actually enter in the values. Then the next thing you want to do on your BMW is figure out how much fuel is in your tank and what the size of your fuel tank is. And I'll show you how to do that on my 440i. Basically, you want to access the hidden menu in the cluster. And this is something that all BMWs have, as far as I'm aware, like E series, F series, even the new G series. So I'll show you how to do it on my car. The process might be a little bit different on your car. So if you look up on YouTube, access the hidden menu on my 335i or whatever, it'll show you how to do that. So what I'm going to do is long press the trip reset button. First, it'll show your service interval reset option. And then the hidden menu comes up. So the first time you do this, you're going to have to put in a security code. It's like the last five digits of your VIN, the sum of them. So if the last five numbers are 11111, then your security code is 5. So you put in that security code, and then it'll start showing a lot of information. Like I said, this is on a lot of different BMWs. It just might look a little different if you don't have this digital cluster. So you scroll through by tapping on the trip reset button, and it'll show all the different options. These are useful for a lot of other reasons, but you're going to scroll until you get to this information. Now, what you're seeing is the tank total and the display value. The top one that says tank total is the actual reading from the sensor in your fuel tank. The issue with that one is it's a float that sits on top of the fuel level. And if you park on a hill, or if you just came to a stop and the fuel's kind of sloshing around, that value can change and fluctuate. The second value that says display value is what's actually shown on your gauge. And that's basically the BMW calculation for how much fuel is actually in your tank that ignores all the variation you can see with different driving conditions and things like that. So I always use the display value. The next thing you want to do is basically fill up your tank with premium fuel and check that number again. So get back into the hidden menu and you'll see what that maxes out at. Mine maxes out at 55 liters, so it's about 14 and a half gallons. And that tells me that it ignores the extra like gallon of fuel reserve that I have in the fuel tank, because my tank is actually 15 and a half gallons. So fill up your fuel tank with 93 octane or 91 octane and check what that maxes out at. And that tells you what your fuel tank size will be. And that'll be the value that you put in the fuel tank size in your ethanol calculator or in your ethanol app. The next thing you want to do is verify the ethanol content on the E85 that you're getting at the pump. The reason why you need to do this is because the actual ethanol content can vary a lot. So E85 obviously implies that it's 85% ethanol, but the way it works, at least in the United States, is it can be as low as 51% ethanol and still be advertised as E85. So you want to test it so that you know the actual ethanol content of what you're getting out of your pump. This is something that you won't necessarily need to do on race gas or bioethanol if you buy it like that, because it's certified to meet a specific ethanol content. But this also works even for the pump gas. So if you're mixing this with like any premium gas, 91 or 93 octane or like 98 RON, you can test this as well to see if it's actually 0% ethanol or maybe even up to 10% ethanol, because again, that's going to contribute to calculating your mix. So the way it works, this is the test kit that I bought. It's one by Fuelit. I bought it on Amazon. There are a lot of different options, so just find one that you like and what works for you. And you're going to fill it up to this first line with water where it says H2O. And then you fill it up the rest of the way with whatever gas you're using, whether it's E85 or premium. And the way it works is that the water will mix with the alcohol in the fuel, which is the ethanol, and the gas will float to the top. So that'll basically tell you how much ethanol is in the gas that you put in here. A lot of people will tell you it's not that accurate because it's really just testing the absence of gasoline. So any other like additives and things like that that mix with the fuel could contribute to the ethanol measurement. But in the grand scheme of things, it's giving you the exact number you need. So this is what I've done. I put E85 in this highly regulated fuel container, and I use this to suck some out, and then I fill it up in here to the line, and then we'll see what it measures. So what you want to do after it's settled is look for this line, and what that is the separation between the alcohol water mix and the gasoline. So mine is measuring about E78. And that's pretty consistent with my local gas station, how it's been. It varies down to E78 in the winter and up to E83 in the summer. So this is kind of like the winter blend. So pretty consistent and still pretty good compared to some stations. So pretty much that gives you all the information you need. You're going to go ahead and go into the app and begin typing in the values. Like I said, my E85 measures about 78% ethanol. And my pump gas I measured separately, it has about 5% ethanol. My fuel tank size is around 14.5 gallons or 55 liters. And then say I've got 10 gallons of fuel in the tank. The actual ethanol content in your fuel will depend on what you're working with. So if you already have E30 or E50 in the tank, put that in. If you just have premium gas, then whatever your ethanol content in the premium gas is what you'll put in that field. And then it'll calculate how much you need to mix. And this works really well too, because if you're maybe filling up gas at a station that's far away and you're putting it in a separate fuel container, you can put that in here as well. You just put in that it's say like a 5 gallon fuel container, and you figure out your ethanol content in each of your fuels, and it'll tell you how much to put into that container so you can fill up at home. One other thing I want to mention is if you're getting a custom tune and trying to determine the best ethanol blend for your car, just make it easier for yourself. But a lot of people will argue about whether E30 is better than E50, etc., etc. And sometimes you'll look online and see people running like a tune on E60 or E70, and people are always asking why. 9 times out of 10, that's just the quality of the pump E85 that comes out of their gas station. So they're pumping full E85, but they're telling you it's an E70 tune because the pump E85 that comes out of there is E70. Or sometimes you'll see people say, oh, I'm tuned on something weird like E43. And the reason it's like that is because they're just mixing 50-50 pump E85 and 93 octane. So, you know, instead of trying to target like a specific blend, just make it easier on yourself. You know, if you want to do 1 gallon of E85 for every 2 gallons of 93 or whatever makes it simple, and you get your custom tune for that, you'll be fine. You know, if it's 1 or 2 points lower than E40 or 1 or 2 points higher than E40, it's not going to make a big difference. And that'll save you a lot of time and scrutiny trying to target a specific blend. So So that's just a little advice. If you're getting a custom tune, go ahead and make it easier for yourself too. If you guys have any questions or comments, leave them below. Thanks.